Today I am going to present you a new tool which generates Node.js TypeScript REST API from MongoDB. So it takes MongoDB as an input and then it generates REST complete proper REST API with REST interface created for the Mongo schema and then with a JWT token authentication. It also generates a Swagger contract. Let's see how this tool works. So I have this folder. This folder you will get once you have the tool downloaded. So you will get a sample database which I have downloaded from internet. Then you will get a generator tool which we are going to use it now. Let me start this tool. So this is the tool. It will help you to generate Node.js REST API. So let me give my demo project name. So let's see, demo node TypeScript database name. So where is my database? I need to see. So I have Mongo installed locally in my system. So I have this database Northwind which I have downloaded from online. So it has some shops, supplies, territories, shippers, regions, products, many things are based on this database. I want to generate a REST API. So let's see, Northwind is my database name. So Northwind small, and then I don't have any username password locally. So whatever the details you will put here, that details will be created for final MongoDB scheme. So some people may have different MongoDB scheme for like remote connection and all. So I have given a flexibility that you can change the final MongoDB script connection string. So let's change it to this. So I have MongoDB localhost as connection string. And then the database name is Northwind. And I want to generate a project demo Node.js. So I'll just do a test connection. Okay, so it's connected. I can click generate. So once I click generate, it will go through this table, these all tables, and generate a REST API for me. Okay, so it's done. It's done quickly because it's local host. So let's see how it's generated. So I have this folder demo Node.js. So it generated in the same folder where the tool was there. And then I have two folders inside. One is Mongo TS Node.js Mongo REST API. Another is Postman import file. So this is the import file. We will use it little later. And this is the code which we have generated. So I have env file set up here. Let's see, open this code in Visual Studio Code. So this is the code I have opened here. So let's check what all routes are there. So I have these many routes generated based on my database. So if I see here, these are my database details. Based on that, these routes are generated. And then if I see the components, so I have the same similar thing. So if I see SOAP, then I have index, interface, model, service, validation. So all the things are professionally written. So let's see if it works or not. So I'll just try a npm install first. Okay, so once we have npm installed, we can start the server. Npm run start. So it will compile all the JS file, TS file, and then generate a build. So if any exception or any error is there, it will show in that this screen. Okay, so we can see there is no exception or error because it's connected to MongoDB. It's saying it's connected to MongoDB and the which port it is started. It's started on 8484 port. So let's go to 8484 localhost. So this is the API, not the website. So we need to use Postman to test this application. So how we can do that? Let's see here. I have Postman here, and if you notice that we have also generated a Postman import file, these two file. So if I import these two file into Postman, so this is my API project which I generated. So Postman is generated based on that. So if I import this, I can see that this is imported. All the collection based on your table name will be there, and then there will be an environment file which define your API URL, and then we have a version and we have token, access token to use this thing. So first endpoint will be to generate a token. So I have auth login as a endpoint, and I have to select the environment variable from here. So I'll select this, and it's pointing to localhost 8484. So just check that. Okay, so access token is generated, and it is going to set the access token to environment variable. So this token is set. So now if I do any call, it will be passed as a access token will be passed as a header in as a JWT authentication. So before that, let's see we have a Swagger generated or not. So I have a localhost 8484 with API docs. So this is the URL. Okay, so Swagger is also generated. So we have auth, categories, customer. So this is based on your table, based on your database table. So if you see here, so I have categories, customers, employee territories, Northwind, order details, orders. So this is based on your table. All the Swagger endpoints are generated. So you don't have to worry about it, that how you will, what you will do after generating the code, how you will understand the code. Everything is generated for you to test or to use, start using in at that instance only. Let's try some other endpoint. So I have a get all for SOC. So if you see this one, so I am passing a barrier token from the environment file. It is already set. If I click send, it will give me the database output, which is my database here. So I have database with these details. Okay, and then if I want to find by get by ID, I can copy this ID. Get by ID, I can go to SOC, click endpoint, and then do this, and this record I got again. And if I want to update this record, I can just copy this, go to update. So this, I have an option that I can update all the properties, or I can just update some of the properties. So let's assume I want to update only open days to Sunday. I want to delete all the days. I want to just keep Sunday as a open day. Okay. So I don't want to pass any other details. I need to pass ID here. I don't want to pass this all. I just want to update for this shop ID. I want to update open day as a Sunday, only Sunday. Okay. So let's send this. Okay. So update is successful. And then if I go to get by ID, I should get a different result. Okay, so you can see that these all codes are generated automatically. You have not written, we have not touched even the single line of code till now. And then you have a delete option, similar way you can pass the ID for the delete. Let's check some other endpoint. So category is there, get all. Okay, so we are getting data. Region is there, get all. Okay, we are getting data. We can do a get by ID here. Okay, so this data is coming. We have customers, get all. So we are getting customers, get by ID we can do. So this is a sample database. So whatever the data is defined, that we are getting. And this all are generated automatically. We have not written a single line of code. So I'll just walk you through some of the code. So let's take example of SOP model. Let me go through the routes from there. So SOP routes are there. So in this, I have first is defined as get. So shop get will call shop component of find all. Then we have post which will create the shop. Then we have patch which will update the shop. Then we have delete, get by ID which will find one, and then we have delete. So these all endpoints are generated automatically, and if you notice, plugger annotation in this all the endpoints. So from shop route it goes to component. So I have component here, so find one is there, then find create is there. So on create we are calling shop service, if you see. So shop service insert. So shop service is nothing but this service model page. So service.ts, so we are doing a find all here, which is actual database call is at this point. Insert, we have actual database call at find one is there, and then this is insert. And we have a proper validation, joy validation we have implemented, which will do a validation for your inputs data. Similar to that, update, we have update call, okay. And then the validation part is written here, like what type of, you can format this document. So what type of application it will take, like open days will take array as an input. It can't take a string as an input. So that all validation we have automatically generated. You don't have to write. Then we have a model. You can check that interface are generated, request interface. Then response interface is there, shop model. Then Mongo schema is generated based on your particular type of data you have in your collection. So this is the all the codes we have generated. We have auth here, which is generating the token actually. So here in this page you can customize your authentication table collection, or you can call some other third party service to get the token generated. So that customization you can do once you have the code generated. So hope this tools make some sense. So this is the tool I have made. So you will get the generator tool preview, then you will get the sample data. There is some help document I have attached. Since hope it serve the purpose to make it automated. Do check all my scripts and see if it is helpful. Report me any bug is there, or any feedback you want to put, any suggestion you want to put. So we will take it seriously and then just implement it as soon as possible. So let me know what you think about it. Thanks a lot. Thanks for watching.